teacher Ava, and today we are going to be reading We're Different, We're the Same, written by Bobbie Jane Cates and illustrated by Joe Matthew. Do you know what the word different means? It means not the same. For instance, most people are the same because we all have noses, but the way they work and look may be different. Now, when I'm reading the story, I want you to see if you can find other ways that we're the same and other ways that we're different. All right, let's take a look.
We're different. We're the same. We're different. Our noses are different. We're the same. Our noses are the same. They breathe and sniff and sneeze and whiff. Our hair is different. Our hair is the same. It grows on us in several places. It warms our heads and frames our faces. Our mouths are different. Our mouths are the same. Their lips form the words we say and smile when it's a happy day. Our skin is different. Our skin is the same. It tells us something's cold or hot, or wet or dry. It knows a lot. Muscles and bones are wrapped inside it. We all have blood and skin to hide it. It keeps in warmth and keeps out dirt. It warns us so we don't get hurt. Our eyes are different. Our eyes are the same. They see, they blink, they weep, they wink. Our bodies are different. Our bodies are the same. They stretch and bend and work and play. They all need food and rest each day. They dance and wiggle and ride a bike. They may look different, but they're all alike. Our feelings are different. Our feelings are the same. Lonely, worried, scared, excited, happy, loving, glad, delighted. We're the same. We're different. That's what makes the world such fun. Many kinds of people, not just one. A rainbow would be boring if it were only green and blue. What makes a rainbow beautiful is that it has every hue. So aren't you glad you look like you? We're different. We're the same. We're wonderful. The end.
What did you notice? I noticed a lot of things that were the same. Like most people have hair and eyes and nose and mouths and bodies, but those things may be different for everybody. For instance, some people may have short brown hair, others may have long red hair. Some people use their mouths to talk, while others use their hands. Some people may have hazel colored eyes, while others need glasses to help them see. Like the book says, we're all different and we're all the same. Our differences is what make us unique, and our sameness is what connects us to one another. Now, I want you to find a mirror at your house, and I want you to stand right in front of it and find what makes you unique. What does your hair look like? Your nose? Your ears? Maybe you can make people laugh. Maybe you're a fast runner or you're a good drawer. I want you to find what makes you, you. Then I want you to find somebody in your house, and I want you to see if you're the same as them or if you're different. Then I want you to get some crayons and paper and draw a picture of yourself and your friends and family and find what makes them unique. Maybe it's the way they look, or maybe it's the things that they can do. All right, have fun. And when you're all done, if you want to send a picture to Teacher Ava, ask a grown-up. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.